In this video, I will show you 10 AI tools you can use to improve and simplify your Arch Viz work. If you enjoyed the video and would love to learn more about these tools, I have created a free AI course where I dive deeper into this topic. The first lessons were just published. All you have to do to join is to download my app and sign up for free. The first tool is Magnific AI, which is an online AI upscaler that can upscale your images up to 16 times. It not only can upscale your images, but also enhance and transform them. This tool is very easy to use. You control just a few sliders. By using it, you have the best of both worlds: creative control over your image and photorealistic AI improvement in areas where 3D is not so great, like natural elements or 3D people. In the free course I mentioned before, we'll go through this example step by step. Here we used 6 different generated images and blended all of them with the original visualization. As I said before, everything is as I wanted, with no random results. I have full control over the final result. This tool is not cheap. It starts at €39 per month plus tax. If it's too expensive for you, don't worry, the next tool will be a cheaper alternative. It says it can make around 200 normal upscales and 100 large ones per month, but I get only 58 upscales out of it, and I think I haven't used 8 and 16 times at all. Still, I think it's worth the money if you do images professionally. Again, the beauty of this method is that your render looks exactly how you wanted it. With the right settings, you don't get a random outcome. You just improve the photorealism of natural elements. Krea was mentioned a lot in the comments section of my video about Magnific AI. It's an alternative to Magnific, which has a free plan. It works similarly, however, the results are way worse on the free plan. Here are a couple of examples. In the free version, you are limited to 2K upscaling, meaning your output image will be only 2048 pixels on a larger site. You need to upgrade to be able to get higher resolutions, which makes the free plan kind of useless. I haven't tried the paid version because I didn't like the result I got for free. I am not sure if the paid version will generate a better quality. Here is a comparison between Magnific and free Krea upscaler. It's not even close. I think Magnific improved my render, but Krea made it worse. It looks like it is drawn with a pencil. This example shows that it doesn't really work with low-res inputs. I added Krea to my list for those of you who are on budget and are looking for free tools to use. Next, Stable Diffusion. It is a deep learning text-to-image model based on diffusion techniques. Unlike the first two tools, it is totally free and runs locally on your PC, and calculates the images by your GPU. The better graphic card you have, the faster the results. The installation process is very tricky. I will show it in the course step by step though. Here we have way more control over the generated image, with all the available controls as well as using the prompts. Similarly to Magnific, I use it to improve my renders, but I don't use it to do upscaling. With this method in mind, you don't have to spend a lot of time in 3D. For example, here I didn't pay too much attention to the 3D people, the water in the swimming pool or the cliffs in the background. Stable Diffusion is perfect for such improvements. Magnific upscale the images and keep them similar. But here, we can have more control to improve the water, for example, and get this really nice looking ripple effect. You would need to spend a lot of time to get this effect done in 3D or Photoshop. Here you still have control over the final result and don't get random outputs, which is very important for professional work. To do it, I use the inpaint option inside the image to image tab, which allows me to paint over areas of my render that I want to improve. This tool can generate only limited resolution. It's dependent on the model we use. In this case, it is 768 by 768 pixels. In this video, I will not go through the basics, so if you don't understand it now, don't worry. I will explain it all in the course. Then the really important setting, the inpaint area. We have to change it to only masked. If we don't do it, the whole output will have these dimensions, which is not what we want. When we change the setting, only the generated result will have these dimensions. If the painted area is smaller than set resolution, the result will be still generated in the resolution we've set, and scaled down to the painted area, resulting in better quality. If the area is larger than these dimensions, the result will be scaled up, resulting in lower quality. So with this method, I generate the pieces that are equal or smaller to the max resolution. I go through my images piece by piece, with 5K images. It takes a while, but it's very easy and the effects are worth it. This tool is super easy to use and is integrated directly inside Photoshop. You just select the area, type what you need, and wait a bit for the result. I use it the most often to expand images. It's a huge lifesaver. There are many other ways to use it, like adding or removing objects, adding reflections, replacing skies, adding shadows, improving on 3D people, or changing clothing, for example. There is a big concern with Adobe though. There was a big controversy a few months ago. Adobe updated their terms of use and they made many users mad. Users of Adobe get a notice that some changes have been made to the Adobe general terms of use. The problem was, you couldn't use the software unless you agreed, and by agreeing, you granted Adobe a non-exclusive, worldwide, royalty-free sublicense to use, reproduce, publicly display, distribute, and modify your content. So basically, they could use your work, whatever it was professional work or family photo edits, to train the AI. Many people were frustrated and started to cancel subscriptions, so Adobe had to react to stop it. At the moment, the terms are updated and it looks fine, but the damage has already been done and it's good to be aware of that. Midjourney has come a long way since I created a YouTube video about it last time. The results are way more realistic, but also now we can use the website instead of Discord to generate images, which I found way more effective and user-friendly. We can now set parameters just with the use of the sliders or choosing the option. Look at these images. They really look like photos. The greenery and the lighting all looks very good. The same for the composition. I like the shallow depth of field in the second example. These images perhaps lack some details, but they are great examples of mode and feel inspiration. I like the composition here. It creates a very intimate look, even though it's the rainy weather outside. Want something more crazy and outstanding? It's not an issue. You can create cool, more abstract results too. I love the colors here. You can see the potential is huge. What is the most impressive though is an editor tool where we can remove some parts of the image and generate new things in that place. Let's imagine that you like the general feel of the image, but don't like the building or material on it. It's not a problem. With the use of an editor, the task is simple and gives you a whole new level of generating experience. You can take the image you like and build on that. You don't have to endlessly generate images till you find the one that matches your idea. It speeds up the process a lot. Midjourney is a perfect tool for looking for inspiration, concept development, creating mood boards, and testing ideas. The subscriptions start from $10 per month, and you can generate around 200 images per month. But if you need to generate many images, then you probably have to go with more expensive plans. Ideogram is another image generation tool from textual descriptions. What is cool here, they have a free plan too. However, it has limited options. If you want to have all the options, you need to go with the Plus plan, which is $20 per month. It's a perfect tool for generating various sorts of graphics, but we can use it for generating architectural visuals too. And the results are very good. I really like the style and realism of the images. The lighting, the summer vibe, all is there. Here, I like the composition created by lighting. This shadow at the front makes the building pop up. I actually think it's a perfect way to study various options with no time. We can describe what we want and then choose in whatever direction we want to go. We can study different lighting, composition, style, and more. The interesting option here is image editor. We can paint over the image to instruct the tool where specific objects should be generated. Ideogram has an option to set the color palettes. I found it doesn't work too great with realistic style images, but it's perfect for graphic design, for instance. Another option is that we can upload or draw a simple sketch and use it as a reference for the composition. Even though Midjourney is more oriented toward generating high-quality artistic or photorealistic architectural images, in my opinion, we can successfully use Ideogram for the same purpose, but also for enhancing architectural visualization presentation with strong graphic design accents. Topaz is a software that can do upscaling and frame interpolation of video footage. It's great to save a ton of time and money when doing architectural animations. With upscaling, you are able to, for example, render full HD footage and upscale it to 4K. If you render full HD instead of 4K, we speed up rendering 4 times. Using frame interpolation, we can render every nth frame, and Topaz will create missing frames based on the rendered images. Here is the math. Let's assume you are using a render farm and will use 4 times interpolation on average across the project plus 2 times upscaling. your bill will be just 1/16 or 6.25% of what it would be if you render all the frames in the final resolution. Sounds good to me. Here are some examples. Here we have a comparison between 2 and 3 times upscaling. The 2 times upscaling looks better, but the difference is not huge. Let's have a look at the frame interpolation. You can see that interpolating every second frame looks fine, but if we move to 4 and 8 frames, we have really noticeable problems. You have to treat each situation individually and do some test renders before to see how far you can optimize each scene. For example, here we rendered every 16th frame without issues because the camera movement is slow and there is no movement in the scene. Here we couldn't do frame interpolation because of the bubbles, but we figure out a smart solution to render the whole image every 8th frame and re-render every frame of a smaller region where the bubbles are, which we place on top. It drastically decreased the render time, as this shot was quite demanding because of a shallow depth of field and caustics. It's all about being smart and flexible. Runway is a tool to generate and edit videos and images to produce video outputs. We can generate video from text prompts and it will create it from scratch. It will require lots of testing and back and forward movement, but still, we can use it for creating some general videos like close-up shots of some natural elements. Another option that will be more useful for ArchViz is generating videos from images. So we just have to upload the image, instruct the tool with the text prompt, and that's basically it. We can get an animated version of our visualization in no time. The results are impressive, even though it doesn't work great with people yet. But I can imagine it will greatly improve in the future. But it not only animates the existing area of the image, it can also add more content to it. Of course, it's not ideal with the building as it doesn't generate it based on actual architectural drawings. But still, we can use it successfully in many cases. Even just to help the client to see how it may look like. Way easier and more convincing than animating the camera and creating the previews, isn't it? They have a free plan, so if you want to test it, you can generate free video projects. Depending on your needs, you can choose from different paid plans. The prices start at $15 per month. Staying at the video topic, Sora is an AI model that can create realistic and imaginative videos from text instructions. This tool is created by OpenAI ChatGPT creators, and unfortunately, it's not available to public at the time of this recording. I've included it because the shown results are looking promising and I think it will be a great tool to use for animations. It probably will replace the stock video and maybe even the green screenshots later on. Another video generator tool is not available yet, but it should go live soon. Firefly models are used for generative fill in Photoshop, and now they have introduced Video AI tool. What makes this tool better than Sora is the integration with Premiere Pro software. It's the same logic as with generative fill in Photoshop, but with the video. You will be able to extend the length of your clips and add, remove or replace objects or add entirely new clips without leaving the software. Also, you will be able to use other models inside Premiere Pro. For example, OpenAI Sora to Runway directly inside Adobe's software. It sounds amazing, but as the controversy with rights to the images shown, you have to be careful with Adobe. Personally, I use DaVinci Resolve as my video editing software, but I hope they will do similar features there. The new tools pop out every day and it's hard to keep up, so if I missed something cool, please let me know in the comments. If you want to learn more about these AI tools and start using them in your workflow, join my free course. Bye bye!